Hello ladies and gentlemen and everyone in between. My name is Helena Hitman. Welcome to my channel. Today I'm gonna do a quick wrap-up of graphic novels by Asian authors I read for Asian Readathon 2021. Well, I was planning to read just 5 graphic novels for 5 prompts, but I ended up reading 7. So let's quickly wrap it up. The first prompt was to read any book written by Asian author, and I chose Skim by Mariko Tamaki and Jillian Tamaki. Are cousins, and they wrote this coming-of-age story about Asian girl who is going through high school, going through this period of time where all the witchy aged teens becoming pretty conforming teens, like a young adult. That's a graphic story about friendship and power dynamic of teacher-student relationships and the clumsy way of how suicide prevention is done in schools often. The art was really, really great. The story, I liked it a lot. I loved the cover art, and overall it was, I guess, 5 out of 5 for me, because it was exactly what I was thinking it will be, and even a bit deeper than I was expecting, because I loved how the friendships was covered up in this story, because the initial friend with whom protagonist was spending the most time with during the novel was definitely not a good person for her, and I really loved who he ended up with, and it was totally unpredictable, and it was just a good and sweet, a bit nostalgic story to read if you want to read something about high schoolers. The second prompt was to read any book with Asian protagonist, and I chose Chicken with Plums by Marjane Satrapi about Nasser Ali Khan, famous Iranian tar player. So the book is set in 1950s Iran, and it's about broken heart, broken marriage, and broken tar. The story is really funny, but in a sad way. Like, I love Marjane Satrapi's sense of humor, and her style, her signature, significant style is presented in all of the works I read from her by now, and this one is not an exception. So the premise of the novel is that there is this famous tar player, Nasser Ali, whose tar is broken by his wife, and he decided to die. So it also has the same suicidal theme that we see in the Skim, but it's written much more directly. And it's more about how the decision to die and the desire to die can be the crucial point of the person surviving his suicide attempt or not. It was sad and funny again. It's very strange to say the book about suicide was funny, but it was. I mean, it's Marjane Satrapi, she is able to do this. So I love the appearance of Islamic Angel of Death Azrael in this, and how the main character was seeing his deceased relatives while he was thinking about his own death, and how he was traveling through time in the future and in the past while he was preparing himself to finish his life on this earth. The next prompt was to read any book written by Asian author in your favorite genre, and my favorite genre in graphic novels is graphic memoir and graphic nonfiction in general. So I chose Zeina, Abirached book, I Remember Beirut, but first, prior to it, I decided to read A Game for Swallows by the same author, and I really adored my decision lately, because A Game for Swallows was about her childhood in Lebanon and memory of her neighbors who is helping her and her little brother to be on their own in their flat while there is a military attack on the city and her parents is not home, and they are coming all together. I loved Ernest and his story, this one neighbor in Game for swallows. I love how Ernest was quoting and performing for kids Cyrano de Bergerac, because this piece by Edmond Rostand was especially loved by me in my childhood, this one about nose. I loved to read it when I was a kid, and it was a part of my childhood, so it was really nice to see that it was a part of childhood of Zeina Abirached as well. And she was born in Lebanon when civil war has been going on for like 6 years already, and this memory of her neighbors, it's not she's not given us any historical context. And I saw in different reviews about this novel that for many people it was a downfall of the graphic memoir, because, you know, it's unlike in Persepolis, where Marjane Satrapi, while she was talking about her childhood and how the war in Iran is going on, she was also given all the historical details and political background of it. But in this memoir, it's just a memoir of her childhood, both of the books. And I think it's good. I think it's totally okay with me. I just read, you know, a Wikipedia article, but I don't think it's absolutely necessary to give, you know, for the author who survived such circumstances to give, you know, the whole all the details of political field at this point, where they were just sharing their childhood memories with you. So I remember Beirut, that I read after A Game for Swallows. It was just pieces of her memories about her childhood, about certain material and non-material things that she remembered from her childhood. Both of the graphic memoirs had very distinguished black and white art and very nice lettering of the text that is used in graphic memoir. And it's not feeling repetitive, even though when I first saw the art, I thought that it may feel repetitive when I read, you know, 100 pages of it, but it did not, and it's really, really great for me to discover such a significant and very different from Marjane Satrapi's, because again, why I'm not comparing these graphic novels, just when we're talking about wartime memoirs in black and white with significant and signature art style, that's the first author who I read from this kind of book, and that's probably the most famous author in this genre with this signature things that you can find in her memoir. But Zeina Abirached did kind of the same. Like, there, it was black and white, it was very nice lettered, if there is a word for this, and it was about her childhood in a wartime, but it was very, very different and very sweet, and I enjoyed it a lot. And also, it's not a coming of age story, it's just a memoir of a child growing up in a place where war is going on, and it's more about children being children, not children becoming teenagers, not teenagers becoming adults. And it's not very reflective, like, it's more a collection of certain moments of her life that she want to have on paper. That's at least what it felt for me. The next prompt was to read a nonfiction book written by Asian author, and I chose The Best We Could Do by Thi Bui. And it was about her family immigrating to United States from Vietnam. And what I did not expect, that this novel is opening up with her delivering a child. And when she's going through delivery, she is connecting with her mother, and she is reflecting on her childhood and on parenthood in general. And I just wasn't prepared for having this visuals, you know. It was not really graphic, like, it was not given in all of the details of childbirth, but it was a bit, you know, not of putting for me, but I would say it was unexpected. So I loved how this memoir reflected on motherhood and what it's like to have a child, but at the same time to be a kid for your parent, because even when we are becoming parents, we are still kids for our own parents. And I loved how much thought she was giving it, and I love how reflective it was, how much of this backstory of her parents' families there was given, because I love generational stories, kind of. And I was given it in this book, And one thing that I especially remembered is how her mother's best memories from her life belongs to period of her life before her mother was married and before she has children, and how it's affecting the kids and what it means for the children to know that you're the most important person in your life, your mom, the happiest moments of her life were before you was born. It was really sad and at the same time really realistic, and I just loved how it was done. And in general, this memory, it's very valuable. The fifth and final prompt was to read any book written by Asian authors that is not US-centered. And I choose Boxer and Saints by Jen Luoyang Yang, that is set in 1890s China. There are two kids growing up, a boy and a girl, and a boy is joins National Rebellion Group, which is trained in Kung Fu to fight the colonizers and Christian priests who feel just way too comfortable in their lands, and they are exploiting the people. They are pushing their religion on native people, and the girl is converted into Christianity. And when I started reading this graphic novel, I would say it's a young adult historical fantasy novel, because but it's really historically accurate. There is just, you know, there are just some aspects I will open up a bit later about it that is was kind of a magical realism for me. This is one book, but it's delivered in two books, separate books. So there is Boxers and there is Saints. And Boxers is about a boy who joins this nationalist group, and Saints is about a girl who joins a Christian church. So when I started reading it, I was rooting for one side of story, of course, for native people who were fighting the colonizers, right? But at the same time, I loved how Jen Luoyang Yang made the story so multifaceted and so deep and detailed and complicated that you understand that you cannot join any side of it. You cannot root for anyone to win, because there is no winners in this war. There is just, you know, much more detail and much more nuance than when we are talking about such issues and when we are taking sides in such conversations. They're just always more details than we are able to state when we are stating our opinion on such complicated and nuanced historical topics. So it was really sad graphic novel. It had no happy ending, but oh, I think that was a spoiler, but I think it's when we are talking about such deep and historically accurate topics, I don't think they have a happy ending, or they should have, because it would have been just not realistic for both of the characters. And both of the characters have their demons and the ghosts that are following them, so that was the part where I felt it was kind of a magical realism. And in general, it was just heartbreaking, but such a great art, such a great delivery, and really, really good coloring. What can I say? It was a perfection. I totally get why it's so popular, and I totally get why people saying it's like a must read. I may say it as well. So I was really happy to participate in Asian Readathon 2021, and see you soon. Thank you for your attention.